Today we're going to talk about the query formula. The query formula is a really powerful way to take a large data set, for example, the population country data we have in red here, and query it so that you can pull back just specific elements of that main data set. For example, here I've pulled a list of the top five by population countries in Asia. And the great thing about that is when you add a little bit of more calculation on here, I've added the rest of the population in, for example, then you can make a chart based on this subset of your main data. This query is great because let's say my main data change, my query data will also update, and then my chart would update. So let's take a look at how we can create this query. Wherever you want to type a query, you start with equals query, open parentheses. The query formula has two main elements, data, which is the main data you want to work with, and the query. You can view this information here about the query for an example. So we'll start with the data. While I am typing in this formula here, I can go ahead and highlight the main data and it will add that in here automatically for me. Then I'll hit the comma to move to the second element, which is the query. In a query function, this formula here, the query always starts with select and it's in quotations. So you have to make it like a string here. If you want to return all the data, you can do select star, end your quotation marks and end your parentheses and hit enter. And now you'll get a second copy of your data from a query. Now this is kind of view only. You can't actually modify any of the numbers in here or it will mess up your chart there. If we want to specify specifically what we want to return, instead of using the asterisk, we would specify first off what columns we want to return by their letter name. So in this case, we have columns A, B, C, and D. So if we only want to return the country name and the 2019 population, that would be A and D. So we could do select A, comma D. And you can see as I'm typing, that red line means something's wrong with my query. But once I get a correct formatted query, the red line goes away. I can hit enter and see my results. So the first part, the select, is how you specify which columns to return. If I want to specify a condition of which rows to return, I can do that with the where part. So I would say select A and D where, and now I'm going to add kind of like a if condition. So there's a lot of different ways to do this. Let's start off by specifying the population size. So column D has population. So I would say where D, and let's say I only want the countries that are smaller than 100,000. We'll do D is less than, and let's do 100,000. No commas here, just the numbers. And if I hit enter, I will see a kind of filtered list here of country name and population for only under 100,000 countries. I can go another element here and sort this list. It might be good to see this from smallest to largest. The sort part would be order by. So I would write order by and the column I want to order by, which in this case to do population is D. And then I can specify either ascending or descending. In this case, let's see smallest to largest or A to Z or ascending. So I'll do ASC. When I see nothing returned, if I scroll down to the end of my main data set, I will see there are some empty rows. So what I'm going to do is select that first row, and then I'll use Control Shift or Command Shift to go to the bottom of the page, right click, delete those rows. So now I will actually see results here because there aren't empty rows that are showing up as the smallest values to enter. So we've talked about the way you can specify which columns to return, and with the where function, which rows, and how to order those. Let's talk about other ways to specify which rows to return. And in this case, we have a region here. So let's specify the region using the where part. So what we'll do here is get rid of the end of our query. We're still going to do A and D, but instead of where the population is a certain size, we're going to do where C or the region, and we're going to start by Europe, saying which ones are Europe. Now, whenever you type a string here, you have to put it in quotation marks. So I'll put Europe in the single quotation marks there. The red line went away, and when I hit enter, I'm only going to see the countries and the populations when column C shows Europe. Now, some of these you'll see Asia comes up as East Asia, South Asia. So if I want to look for the word Asia, I could say where C contains, and then I can put Asia in the quotation marks. Now, it's important to know that this is case sensitive. So when I typed lowercase a for Asia, it didn't work. When I make uppercase A, you'll see that I then get matches. Now, the really cool thing you can do with this where part, this condition of which rows return, is you can actually have more than one together. So I can say here, I want columns A and D where C contains Asia and where D is greater than, let's say 1 million. So I put in my two-part where query here, hit enter, and now as I scroll down, I'll see it is filtered by that. The other thing I can do here is if I only want to return some of the results, I can use a limit. So at the end of my query, I can say limit 10, for example, and I will only get the top 10 that match my query. I can add the order by here if I want to order it by, let's order it by the country name. Oops, the order by has to go before the limit. There we go, order by A ascending, and now I have that query. So you can see that it is a very powerful function to really pull what you want. And then again, the benefit of this is that you can take this data out and do a calculation on it without having to worry about the other numbers in the main data affecting it. When I select these populations, for example, in the bottom here, I see the sum automatically. I can click on it to see the average, for example. I can highlight this, and then I can make a chart of just this data. And again, it's going to be linked to these columns and rows here. If the data in the main data set changes, the query results will change and my chart will update, but it will always reflect this here. When you're working in the query formula and you click on the drop-down or get the question mark to open this up, click on Learn More, and there's a couple of resources that are really helpful for working with this. This main page here, you can kind of scroll down through this and see several examples of how to use it. And this link here to the Google Visualization API, when you start to do more advanced work with query, this can be helpful to figure out more about how to use all of the different tools you can use. So we talked about select, where, order by, and limit, but there are more options in here. There's pivots and groups and all different kinds of things you can do with this. Take a look at those resources and try out the query formula.